Hello students, welcome back to the new video. In this video, we are going to continue the ongoing chapter number 15, Light. In today's session, we will discuss about the characteristics of images formed by mirrors and also the uses of plane and spherical mirrors. First of all, we will discuss about the characteristics of images formed by a plane mirror, concave mirror and convex mirror. First property, real or virtual. The image formed by a plane mirror is virtual. The concave mirror is, except the when the object is kept near to the mirror, it is real. And in a convex mirror, it is always virtual. Second, erect or inverted. In a plane mirror, the image is always erect. In a concave mirror, it is erect when the object is between focus and pole and inverted for all other positions of the objects. And in a convex mirror, it is always erect. Next, size of the image. In a plane mirror, the image formed is of the same size as that of the object. In a concave mirror, it is magnified when the object is between focus and pole. It is magnified and real when the object is between focus and center of curvature. And it is diminished when the object is beyond C. In a convex mirror, it is always diminished. Next point, the distance from the mirror. In a plane mirror, it is always same size as that of the object. In a concave mirror, distance of real image from the mirror reduces as the object moves further from the mirror. And in a convex mirror, it is always between focus and pole. Now, we will see the uses of plane mirror. The regular reflection caused by a plane mirror can be used to record pictures for television shows. Second one, a large plane mirror hung above the table at an angle of 45 degrees to the surface of the table allows a television camera to record what is on the table. Such adjustments of mirrors are useful in recording science quizzes and cookery television programs. Next one, the regular reflection caused by plane mirror is also put to use in making a periscope to observe objects which are at a different level from the eyes. A periscope uses a plane mirror. Plane mirrors are used in microscope to illuminate the object you want to observe. Now we will see the uses of concave mirror. First one, they are used as reflectors in torches and car headlights to produce a strong parallel beam of light. Second one, they are used as concentrators in solar cooker and solar power stations to focus the parallel beam of sun rays at one point. Next, they are also used by dentists to view a magnified image of the teeth of a patient for an easy diagnosis of the symptoms of tooth decay, etc. They are used as shaving mirrors to see a larger image of the face. Now, we will see the uses of convex mirror. First one, they are used as street light reflectors because they are able to spread light over a bigger area. As the convex mirror always forms a diminished image and covers a wide range, it is used as a street light reflector, as it can cover a larger area. Second use, they are used as rear view mirror in vehicles because the mirror can diverge a beam of light and makes a virtual image. Here also, for whatever the position of the object it may be, a convex mirror always forms a diminished virtual and erect image and cover a wide range of area. Therefore, it is used as a rear view mirror in vehicles.
Start.
Next one, convex mirrors are used as security mirror in shopping complexes and large shops to keep an eye on customers and shoplifters. So students, I hope you have understood the topics very well. But still, if you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. I will surely try to solve it as early as possible. Here are some review questions. Please solve it in your notebook. Thank you.